apocalypse.
Welcome, Stunner School fans, Bubble fans all around the world. It is Dub Schools Part 2. the recap for Bugmans Brewery, and hopefully Seth Anonymous and Altdorf as well. Part 1 had the recap of Budweiser's and Overworld's Glory. So if you're looking for them, look for Part 1 on my YouTube channel. This is Part 2. Right, let's get cracking then. I'm going to try and fit all three of these play pools into this video. Obviously, some games have already been played. This was a big play pool, wasn't it? This was Bezos' play pool. This is a play pool I was really liking to do well this season. Let's have a look. Right, so blind luck and CL crack. I do believe I won with blind luck. And I do believe they won in week 6 as well. So they're on a bit of a roll all of a sudden. This was the team, if you remember when we did the pre-cap, everyone was talking about, obviously the coach, Big Bad John. And we ended up tipping him because of the rep he had. And he got some really not great dice, to be honest. Not much has gone right, but these last 2 weeks have gone right. And he got himself a big win here because Whitley's cracking have been doing well also. This is some really good coaches in here. This is the play pool what really excites me. And I think Bezo is going to be cashing in on a few trophy winners by the end of the season. Although the other four play pools will totally disagree with me there. So, not many hand breaks. It's elves. What do you expect? 36 blocks to 27. So, obviously, the wood elves got the more blocks. One injury, one KO. Two against two injuries, one KO. So nothing brutal there. Interesting though, the Kraken had 56% ball possession. So they actually dominated the ball possession, but unfortunately couldn't dominate the score. Interesting game, because like I said, both very, very good coaches. Don't know much about them, obviously, coming into the into Sons of Skulls, but obviously, usually that makes me show more interest to see how good these coaches are not seeing play before. But I was told, I think, Dragoon spoke very highly of, obviously, G Whitley. And, obviously, everyone's speaking very highly of Big Bad John. So this was always going to be a good game. And like I said, not much in it. 2-1 in the end of the day. So, you know, pretty good all round. Obviously, Blindlock got the big win. But again, Seattle Kraken did well with the XP as well. Let's quickly have a look at the leaderboard then. Let's have a look. So Blindlock's won the last two. So it's a bit of a late run up there. The Bumblebee's doing well. Bezos up there as well. It's interesting, though. It's still, again, was talking about... do you know what? I just remembered something. I'll come back to it in a minute. I was just talking how competitive the Overworld's Glory was. But one thing I did forget is, like, it's a top three of each player pool, but one player pool, the best fourth place runner-up can make it as well. And that's massive. Because there's a few of these, like the Overworld's Glory and this one here, where there's a lot of people still fighting for the SAS trophy. So all of a sudden, that does bring in other teams. For instance, obviously, Blindlock and Seattle Kraken, who are still an outside chance. Or maybe not Blindlock, because they've played this week, haven't they? But maybe Seattle Kraken's still got an outside chance. Got to remember that. One of the four-place team, best four-place team gets through. Got to remember that. So let's have a look at Seattle Kraken then. Free win city. They've still got their strength for catchery still there. He's gone block instead of dodge first. It's sort of just your own personal preference. He's got a catcher there. So again, it's a very early developed team. This team came in late and they've done extremely well, taking on some of the more established teams. He's got, again, he's looking like the wood and not blue or the knuckles nuts for this team, really. What's not bad. Like I said, the good thing about all the playoffs is they're all really good. Yeah, the SS trophy is the elite trophy. We get that. But they're all good. They all have good things. And I think the knuckle nuts is the one I'd want to win. Not being funny, but... Sand Bears or dice? Yes, please. But again, obviously, win against the Cowboys. beat the Coffee. That's a massive win there. Got a bit of a whooping. Well, I say whooping, but got beat by the Bumblebees. Drew with the Town Strangler. They're there or thereabouts. Very early into their franchise history. But again, you know, I certainly won't back against them not getting a cheeky playoff run down the line. Blind Luck all of a sudden getting some momentum. Bit too late maybe for this season's SAS Trophy. Be interesting to see if he comes back with these or does something different next season. 13 players, he'll have 12 for his final game. But again, you know, his war dancers are good. Chili 5 catches, beautiful. Strength 3 catches, just as good. Well, not it's still good. Got guard catcher as well. All of a sudden, this team's starting to develop. Strength 4 lineman, yeah, don't know about that, but I suppose you've got to take it. He's got a kicker as well. So this team's now starting to develop, and if they can not roll as many bad dice like loads of ones, this team could do something this season. Big Bad John is well respected in the Blue Ball circuit. I've never really seen him play much, but obviously people who I respect their coaching level said this guy can play. And they'll say he's got 2 wins now. So he could end up anywhere really. He really could. Like I say, he lost 2-1 to the Howls. Lost 2 to the Norse. So he's been thereabouts. So just against the Guanamo Coffee, who he lost 3-0 to. That's the only really one he's been smashed. But it happens to the best of us. So be interesting how he does in the final rounds. Right, this is a good one. Dice Mans versus Guanamo Coffee. So this was one, Loughle versus Kennard. This is one I really wanted to see. Didn't get to see those. So I was a bit gutted. You know, the Dice one's got it done, you know. Getting it done, 37 blocks to 27. 4K is one injury. Against 1K, one injury is there as well. He dominated, look at that, 75% ball possession. So the Dice ones really did just absolutely dominate this game. Coffee just couldn't live with them. It's as simple as that. Looking at the stats anyway. Dice man's got a decent amount of XP as well. So, you know, a good hit out for the Dice Man's 15-15 there. A little bit of XP, but nothing crazy for Guanamo Coffee. But that's a big win for the Dice Man's. It really is. That puts him into second. And that means now that puts the Coffee down to fourth. Or joint fourth with the Norse. So that makes this a really exciting playoff duel now. And who they got in week 6 of Coffees? They've got, the Norse. That's going to be a cracker. The Dice Man's play the new team in. I have no idea why he's called it that. That's Lone Wolf Jackson's team. Stranglers against the Bumblebees. That'll be quite good. And, Howls versus Cracker will be good as well. So, yeah, this is really, really good week 6 thing. Did I have a look at the teams? I can't remember if I did. Now, I'm just going to go back to them and have a look. So I don't think I'd see the teams. So there we go. So he's got Grab and Guard on his Ogre. Grab might be to help the one turn, maybe. Obviously, then you've got your Blitzers. 4 Guard Blitzers. Might blow a Tackle Blitzer there as well. He loves his Guard. He's got an Agility 4 Throw, what's beautiful. Agility 4 Catcher. Sad stepping Bludge Catcher as well. So, you know, already decent. 12 players, 15-90 is not bad on the TV as well. And again, he's won 2 championships with Blood and Tears as well. The guy knows how we know what he's doing. And I think this is his first. He doesn't use a player human, so this is sort of one of his first stabs. And he's done very well. Done extremely well. I mean, look, he's yet to be beat. 3-2-0. There's his record. Drew with the Bumblebees. Drew with the Howls as well. So an extremely good record. And I'd be surprised if this team doesn't get in the SAS Trophy. And then a Guanamo Coffee. Kennard. Love this guy to bits. Let's see. 3 wins, 2 losses. So Vanilla, the Guard Saurus, is out this week. Is it an MG or is it worse? It's just MG. So he's got block on 4 of his other 5 Saurus. He's got strength 3 skink, a blood skink, chauffeur skink, microwaved egg sandwich for his crocs. So yeah, he'd like to see his crocs develop a bit. But again, this is another new team. Always hard. We saw Dragoon do extremely well, getting to the semi-finals with his very limited Lizard team in Season 1. So, you know, Kennard, you know, he could quite easily go one better. I won't put against him. He knows how to play the Lizards. Kennard usually plays Lizards. And he's going to be there or thereabouts. Obviously, the loss this week hurts him. He plays Kisner Fred. Yeah, well, that's a big game. Whoever wins that probably stops the other team from making the SAS Trophy and putting themselves with a massive chance in the SAS Trophy. And he ends up with Malice Cowboys, who's had an absolute nightmare. So he'll find himself in that, although if Claude's fire is in trouble. But yeah, the Bumblebees got it done again. This is always going to be a tough game for the Norse. The Bumblebees are a scary team. 79 breaks to 8. 62% ball possession. We know that they like to keep hold of that ball as long as they can, the Dwarfs. For sure. Let's have a look. So we've got 42 blocks succeeding against 47. So the Norse actually threw more blocks, but look at that. 6 Ks, 5 injuries, 2 kills. Just absolutely brutal. So let's have a look. Sorry, I just had a message there to just take care of. So yeah, he actually got more blocks, but again, the AV Nan obviously held it for the Bumblebees. Bumblebees, yeah, I'll call that. And the worst thing for the Norse is they only did 6 XP and 5 of that won on the loaner. I don't know if he took the loaner or not. But yeah, again, the Norse will want to forget. The question is, looking at the teams, did they break a lot of things? Well, the Bumblebees we know will be pretty fit, pretty healthy going into their next game. Well, I say that, Zinc's out. So yeah, that's not good. You know? Bloody hell. Sorry. The only problem is when you're recording like this by yourself. Get important messages. So what is it? Yeah, FNG. So his opponent this week will be thanking him. Or did he play his week 6 game already? No, he hasn't, no. So the Stranglers will be very happy that that guard's not playing this week. Again, look at this. How much guard's that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 guard already. He's got his Pommer. He's got another Mighty Blow plus move Troll Slayer as well. Got 2 nice runners, all that Niggle, but it's been Niggle for quite a while. And now he's adding Longbeard's here. So it's 13 plays, 12 plays this week. It's just, you know, this is, again, a team will do well. And I expect them to go very close in the SS Trophy. I really do. Poor old... well, let's have a look at this now. The Norse need to win this week, bear in mind. Let's see what they've got left of the team. Well, every time... what is it with these Yetis? Yetis, yet again, not here this week. Jesus. Oh, he's got a Niggle as well. Oh, it's a Niggle day, but he's got blocks. He's probably going to keep him. That bloody DeMarco, such a bully, isn't he, DeMarco? Such a bully. The rest of the team is looking pretty cool, though. I think, has he always had just the one Berserker? I don't remember seeing him have 2 Berserkers. So he's still got his 2 Wolf War and he's got a Berserker. I'd be looking for another Berserker, me. I love Berserkers in their Norse teams. Deep on Lyman. Yeah. It's tricky, but he's done really well as Root, a.k.a. John Potter. Another coach I've been very impressed with, skill level wise, and just a good egg, really. You know, nice lad. So I hope he does well. And like I say, it's hard to get some of these teams off and running, but he's done well. Obviously, beat Blind Luck as well, beat the Cowboys, only lost 2-1 to the Dicemans. you know, the Bumblebees was always going to be a bad matchup, even though he still got more hits. But, you know, I really respect that he got more hits in that. But again, they got to win this week. Will they win this week, though? That is the question. Well, the Howls, well, this was like a banana skin game for Bezo. This was a game we expected him to win, but how many times have we said that? And he's not. He had a bad first season. They've done a lot better this season, though. 15 armor breaks, 4 chaos oranges, so yeah, he massively got great dice. He only threw 30 blocks, and he got 8 removals. 30 blocks, 15 armor breaks, so you know, he keeps going on about his bad dice, but I'll tell you what, these last 2-3 weeks, his dice have been pretty shit up. So, like I said, it swings around about with dice. If you're a good coach, though, you're more likely to get it done. Bit opposite to the Sentinels. The Sentinels had a great first season and had a bad second season. The Howls had a bad first season, but now we're having a very good second season. Nice lot of XP there as well. The Krasgo's swiped up all the lovely levels, or XP, sorry, for his team. So he at least leveled up. But yeah, Howls looking good this season. They're starting to fulfill the potential. Be interesting to see what he does next season if he keeps with the Howls. Or Bezo goes to Lizards. Well, quite a few people won't. Looking at his team then, so he's got his 2 Mighty Blow Wolves. I mean, they're both movement down as well. This is a real nice team. You can understand why you probably wouldn't want to switch. Because this team now is starting to really fulfill its potential. Block Guard on a Flesh Golem. And that's the one with glasses, I just like to add. The one without glasses has only got block. 2 brilliant. These wolves, beautiful. They're absolutely beautiful. Best wolves in the league. Strength 4 white, so he's at a level, I think. Movement 5. Yeah, you can get away with that. You can always look for maybe a transfer later on. Block guard. Guards love on zombies. A DP zombie. Another DP zombie. Guard ghoul. A ball carrying ghoul. This is a really good team. He's got 200k in the bank as well. This is a beautiful team. Let's have a look. Right. Yeah, I mean, 13 players. What else can you say? Good coach as well. This is going to be a team what's going to do really, really well this season. Like I said, last season, just nothing went right for the Howls last season. Very frustrating for Bezo, but credit to the guy. He stuck with them. And, you know, he's now getting his just rewards. So, you know, these are going to be dangerous. Obviously, he's the captain of this player pool as well. I expect this player pool to do really, really well. So, you know, good luck to him, I think. So we'll have to see, you know, how it goes. All right. So that was Howls, the Cowboys. Well, the Chaos teams haven't done really, really well, have they? Early days on schools, we saw everything went wrong with Nick's Chaos team. Bully the Mano. I wouldn't worry too much, Storm, because your team's healthy and next season they'll be a nightmare. I would not quit this team this season, even if you lost every single game from now. As long as the team's healthy and get some skills, then you've got to keep this team. You know? I mean, this is going to be dangerous. Sorry, I'm just getting... Right. Misses at work, but she's got important stuff. So, got to reply to her so I get shot. Obviously, he's got a potential, if he wants to, agility 4, strength 4 case where he could become a ball carrier if he really wanted to. I've had one before and they've been pretty good. I prefer my warriors though, if I'm being honest, to be fighting and blocking. I still prefer a beastman carrying the ball, especially at, he's got extra movement. But it is what it is. Like I say, this team is going to really cause him carnage. It may be this season, maybe next season. I'm pretty sure the Iguana Coffees won't be happy seeing this team week 7. Because this team could seriously just break them Saurus to pieces. So, I appreciate the frustration for poor old Storm Saxon. My advice to him, though, unless you really, really start losing pieces, keep with them. Keep with them. You know, I've just talked about the Howls who had a horrible season last season. I mean, they had a really horrible season. And look how good they're doing now. And I think the Cowboys next season will be a massive danger. Because that's what Chaos are. Chaos and Nagel, always bad early starters. But eventually, all the hard work gets paid off. And yeah, you won't want to play this team next season. That is for sure. Right. Finally, the Plague Town Stranglers. They played the new kid on the block. That was the undead of Lone Wolf Jackson. And a 0-0. We don't get to see many 0-0s. And there's 31% ball possession for both teams. So, you know, that's always interesting. It's very interesting to see 0-0. Do you know what I mean? It's really, really weird. 55 block against 44. So the Nagel got the better of that. 2 KOs, 3 injuries. But again, look at that. Look at what the undead do. 1 KO, 3 injuries, and 2 kills. Probably, I think if I remember correctly, they were mainly rotters. But still, you know? Still impressive. Again, like I said about the Chaos, it's always going to be a struggle early on. I think he's had a problem with one of his Pescos keeps dying. He's got a bit of Mighty Blow there as well. Very nice Beast of Nagel. That's a beautiful Beast of Nagel. His Nagel Warriors are going well. He's got himself a Ball Carrier. He's probably going to be maybe an Enforcer, maybe. I don't know what he's going to do with these two. Only 10 players at the moment. He's got 50k in the bank. He's probably going to save that for now. Might as well go with a loner rotter. Like I said, the problem I had with my Nagel was I never fucking regened. Never regened, and that's always what frustrated me. But again, you know, another good coach. Another team what just needs patience. This is a new team this season. And again, as long as he doesn't lose key pieces, this will be dangerous next season. And they're still going to be competent even this season. Again, 3 draws, 2 losses. That's not bad for early Nagel. So, you know, you just got to hang in there. Early deals with these sort of teams. And also this team, I mean, like I say, he's just put just letters for his name. Great start for them. He's a zombie. A zombie's out. No big deal there. But look at guard, mighty blow. Wrestle tackle on a goal. Mighty blow tackle. Mighty blow block guard. So he has got some really good pieces. 200k in the bank. 1340 TV. Oh, that's 1290. He's got blow. 2 rerolls. Maybe look to buy, maybe buy another reroll. A bit expensive in it, but coming into the playoffs, you want 3 rerolls. And ironically, in his first ever game, he's probably might have done enough in one game to not go in the Mugmerty ball either. So that's the thing as well, you see. When he goes to the playoffs, I mean, obviously at the moment, it looks like he'll go in the Knuffles Nuts. If he gets in the Knuffles Nuts, then obviously playoffs, you really want three reroll. So that's the thing I'd say about that. Right, so leaderboard then. There we go then. The Bumblebees seem pretty. Dice Man's looking good as well. Howl's just behind them. Iguanimo Coffee there. Schizofresica there. Like I say, 1-4 place finisher will make it as well. Right, I'm going to go with the Howls against the Kraken. I think the Howls have started to get the momentum. Bezos playing well. The dice are not screwing him. So I'm going to go with the Howls there. Although, again, would surprise me if the Kraken gets them out of it. They're strong against the Bumblebees. I can't go against the Bumblebees. The Bumblebees are prime, ready to go. Yeah, they haven't got the Pommer, but the Strangler's are still learning the way. And the Bumblebees, massive amount of guard will get it done. Lone Wolf Jackson's HGG team, I think they're going to get run over by the Dicemen. So I'm going to go Dicemen in that one. And the match of the round, really, is the Schizofresnik against the Guanamo Coffee. This is a really, really tough one. Who really would have liked it yet for this game? He doesn't have it. I'm going to go with the Coffee. I think they get it done this week. Triple B Banker is going to go to the Dicemans. I think they haven't lost ever in Sons and Skulls, and they'll get it done this week, I think. Some big games, though, coming up. Right, let's go on to the next one, then. Seth is anonymous, then. No games being played this week. Ah, that's nice. So there we go. There are the games. Let's have a look at the leaderboard. So, hori ha ha. Some of the admins are doing really well, aren't they? The admins are doing quite well. They're all leading from the front. Armac there with 4 wins and 1 draw. You're a lizard, Harry. That's the one I was really sweet on the beginning of the season. He's up there still. Akari's doing well with his elves. Hawker, like I say, he's done well when he's played. He's just not played all his games. Putting up some spoilers, they're always going to be there or thereabouts. The Shitebag Steelers, obviously Dragoon's favourite and one of my favourites, the Raziel Wolf. The Alcatraz, again, another early chaos. And poor old Tony bringing up at the bottom there. So the Guardians got it done against the Alcatraz. Good, good result for them. The Elves getting it done. 7 armor breaks to 9. But possession overall, 37-12, so the ball must have been on the floor a lot. A lot of blocks thrown as well, so it's a very physical game. 41 blocks to 43. And the Alcatraz, 4 injuries, 2, sorry, 4 KOs, 2 injuries, so they actually got the removals as well. Don't know when they got the removals, but you know, they did get that. 3 pass 3 catches for the Guardians, 2 pass 2 catches for the Ultra. So SPP was getting done. You know. But what have we got there? 11. 14 points for the Guardians. 14 points for the Alcatraz as well. So SPP galore. Everybody's happy. Like I said, again, these are two, if I remember correctly, two quite young teams. Well, I know the Alcatraz are. Oh, Benny the Care Stalker, what a hero. He's 1 point away now from getting to the level. That's unfortunate, isn't it? He's had that a while now, but every time I say it's a bit unfortunate. He's just like a Nurgle warrior now without the cool stuff. Randy Ratt's looking. Oh, interesting. He's gone strip ball. That is interesting. That is really interesting. I thought he was going to be the ball carrier. That's interesting because he hasn't got wrestle either. So, wrestle and strip ball would have gone a lot better than blocking strip ball. So, I think he's going to be a bit of everything, I think. But yeah, that's interesting. Cyrus Virus, I think he's going to be a. He's going to be a killer. He's definitely from Conair, I'm sure, he's Cyrus the Virus. But again, like I said about the other Chaos and Eagle team, this is an early team. Obviously, Beers knows what he's doing with his Chaos teams. He knows it takes a while to get them going. He's got 14 players, all good. Maybe if you've got a few graveyard games, he might be able to maybe replace this guy. He might just keep it, though. Early development, but they're getting there. They're getting there development-wise. Doing all right for themselves. Got to win, got to draw this season, so jobs are good. And you see what playoffs are going to as well. Might be the Nuffle Nuts. Maybe they want some of those bears or sand dice. And Akari, 2 wins, 2 draws, and a loss. So they're doing really well. They've got a chance of SAS Trophy. They, you know, they could go with the big boys. They've got a blitzer out this week. And again, you know, there's not loads of skills here. So, you know, credit to Akari for a good season with very little. But again, Elves are very competent with very few skills. And again, under a good coach, it's proven again here. He's got a runner as well there. He's got himself a Witch Elf down there as well. 14-30. Not bad. Used as a bench as well. Got used as 13 players, got 12 players for this one. So, I always like, I know it makes him a lot high TV, but I do love elf benches because I always think if you've got 13 players, as long as you don't roll loads of double ones, you're always going to have 8 plus players on the pitch, usually. And we know with elves, with 8 plus players on the pitch, you're always going to have a good chance. But yeah, again, another team developing nicely. He's got himself a tackle strip ball there as well. That's interesting. He's got some guard. He's got a bit of mighty blow as well. So yeah, they've got, you know, pieces there what can help. Battle of the Admins here. Hawker, couple of Raptors against the Hayahara of Armac, 2-2. 12 arm breaks to 13. Like to see Hawker play Lizard, see how he does. 56 blocks, he got a lot of blocks in. 42 is still a decent amount as well from Hayaha. 5Ks, 2 injuries, 3Ks, 3 injuries. The Raptors dominated the ball possession. 104 yards running as well, so all good there. SPP wise, Hayaha just probably got better of it. 2-2, I mean, like I say, I think Armac will be happy with that. The Raptors are still in with a shot as well. They're going to get very dangerous when they got a few more skills, I'm sure of it. Look at the leaderboard. Where is he? So he's in fourth, so he's still got potential to make the SAS. But yeah, the Necro looking good at the moment. Looking very, very good. And if we look at the teams, so he's gone for guard. Guard's been his key. He's got 3 guard already. So, as soon as he's got block, he's gone guard. He's going to try and dominate the middle with strength 4 and guard. What's not bad. It's not a bad philosophy. The only problem with that is they will level up a lot slower. So he's got no enforcer really. Unless you want to say the Quattro's enforcer. It's got an agility 4 skink. That's beautiful. You don't really need many good skinks. So he's got his agility 4. He'll obviously be hoping to build around that. And then the other skinks are just there just for an annoyance and just as a backup. 1440 TV. So, you know, that's not bad. And he has a bench. So all good. He just hasn't played many games. So if Hawker can now get on a good roll and play his games, then, you know, the world's the oyster for another good Lizard team and another good coach. Obviously, we've seen Drunken Monk with it one, and now we've seen Hawker one. Hawker's good with just about any team you give him. Very good coach. Very, very good coach. Right, let's have a look. So that was them. Who were the team? Of course, how can I forget the Hori Har Har? Just want to make sure I don't forget anyone. So, again, we've seen the Howls and we've seen this team. AV7 is a bit of a blow for Sir Francis Drake, unfortunately. Blackbeard, the werewolf there, and moving out basically like a bear's a wolf, really, isn't it? Edward England needs a bit of mighty blow and then he'll be happy. Plenty of zombies to chew through. He's got himself a ball carrier, a bit similar to Bezo. Just difference is Bezo's got another beautiful wolf, and that movement now with mighty blow, that's the only difference really. But again, Alex played well this season. He'll be hoping not to play Jimmy. Jimmy seems to be the one who knocks him out of stuff. So he'll be hoping not to bump into him, I'm sure. But again, you know, smart that he's got two goals with glasses. I like that. Shame about Seth Francis Drake, though. Shame about. I do like David Jones, though. He's a really nice piece, is David Jones. Even the, I mean, this Wolf, oh, yeah, I'm going to make a blow. He's still good. Still a blodge tackle piece. DP kicker. He looks like he's on borrowed time, a goal with Niggle. Squeak sandwich chaos. I can understand that. Undefeated. What more can you ask for? The Shitebag Steelers against the Blood God Despoilers. The Shitebag Steelers got it done. He got it done. It's a very unusual for them to get the win, but they did. 12 armor breaks to 6. He's troll leveled as well. 62% ball possession for the Orcs. Jesus Christ. Bloody hell. They really wanted to win this week, didn't they? You know? Unbelievable. Unbelievable. 62% ball possession. you have to see Raziel Wolf to play. To be fair, though, sometimes he does hold the ball, doesn't he? He just doesn't score. He's like, ah, 10-8, let's put foul in because, you know what? We don't worry about the ball. Two passes, two catches, 49 blocks against 50. 99 blocks were thrown. The Disposal's got the more of the injuries, though. The injured three killed one. That's typical Badger. The Badger just have a knack of breaking shit. That's why it's always a worry. I love Badger a bit. The true gentleman, but his team's usually now to break shit. It looks like the this time round it was the Badgers team who was like, you know what, we don't want the ball, we just want to kick the crap out of the Steelers. We're here, the Steelers are a pretty tough team. Let's see how tough they really are. But yeah, they got it done. And again, though, the Blood Brothers Spoilers might have lost the game, but a nice bit of XP moving forward. 15, you know, and 13 for the Shitebag Steelers on the bottom. Pretty alright, to be fair. Let's have a look. I'm going all the way around. There we go. He loves his manos, doesn't he? He loves them manos. So there's his mano. All jolly good. He'd love block on that, wouldn't he? He'd love block on that. And again, the Hail Mary. He loves his Hail Mary kick. He always does unique pieces. That's not a bad piece. And then he's obviously got claw down there. He's my blow. Needs block on that desperately. This one always triggers me. Should have been my blow, not guard, in my opinion. But again, you see, he's only got two guards. So, but again, this, I mean, this is our most seasoned Chaos team. But again, they need time. Chaos and Nagel teams always need time. And they're only going to get more and more deadly as the seasons go by. And, you know, they might have lost the game, but you know what? They kicked the Shitebag Steelers' ass. A lot of people might think that's more important. And there we go. A niggle on the thrower. Obviously, Troy Polamalu there. AG2 on the blitzer. Well, he basically just jumps on people, so he ain't really bothered. The troll got AV. I took AV on a troll once before, just for the shits and giggles, and he lasted about 5 games before someone killed it. I was gutted. They weren't even with claw. But yeah, that's good. Could have took movement, but he's like, nah. I want my troll to have full armor. So I respect that. Again, this team's good. This team, if Raziel really wanted to try and win something, he could. He really could. Because the team's good enough. He just likes to fight. And he's an orc, and I respect that. I totally respect he wants to fight instead of scoring. But at least this week, he got it good. He got it done. Well done, you know. Nope, lost there, no. He drew with the Gitlords. That was an admin. I tipped Alcatraz to win that one. He's been competitive every game he's played. And finally, Yorl Lizard Harry versus Gobsmack Gitlords. Source got it done. Nice, nice level up there, I do believe, for good old Grindelwald there. 12 arm breaks to Favre. Tony, again, not the best of luck with his goblins, unfortunately. They tried to give it as good as they could get, but in the end, the lizards got it done. Again, 37% ball possession, not hugely massive against 12. 33 block against 24. But the 6 inches of 4 chaos was a big thing. Obviously, when goblins go splat, they go splat. And when things go wrong for goblins, they go very, very wrong. When they go right, they go very, very right. But unfortunately, this time it didn't. SPP, well, it was a big, massive fest of XP for the lizards. Beautiful for them. Jesus, what did they get there? 23. And poor old Tony and the goblins got an MVP. And that was that. Very unfortunate. But it is what it is. 2 expulsions as well, so they're trying to foul the crap out of him, and the ref won't have any either. Look at the team. Look, Tony's team doesn't really change much, to be fair. But there we have it. He's got block, tackle, extensions, always. Good old Dickie. He's still there. And Flange Fat as well. Jesus Christ. He's there as well. But apart from them, there's not really much there at all, is there, to say about. He's got a sneaky goblin. He's got a bomber. Sack Ripper Fen. Is it Fredericks? The loony? I can't see Fnatic, though. Did he lose his Fnatic? That's a shame if he's lost his Fnatic. Fnatics are great. So. Your Lizard Harry needed a win. Got the win. Dumbledore's out this week, though. I think it's just an MNG, but I will double check. Yeah. A lot of MNGs this week. And he's gone a different route to Hawk. Hawk's gone block guard. He's gone the more aggressive route. Block, might blow, tackle. I prefer this route just because it just speeds the... Or it should speed up the XP and leveling. He's got a break, tackle, wrestle piece. I assume that's going to be his ball sacker. He'd love a dodge on that bad boy. Block guard, bit of guard in there as well. Been to see what he does with Malfoy. Movement 9. Skink's beautiful. Diamond tackle skinks. And then a blodge skink in Podmo. Yeah, it's a really nicely built team. The only problem is when Dumbledore comes back, the TV is quite high for what it is, but it does have a bench of 2 when they're all fully fit. So, you know, again, great coach. This could go under the radar, this one. But definite. Right. So what's that then? Where are we at now? Is that them all done? It is. So gonna go to week 6 in a minute. That's just the table again. Not bad. Let's predict then. Enrage Guardians versus Higher Hal. This is a tricky one. I think the Elf Guardians can get some out of this. I'm going to go with a draw. I think the Guardians get something. What will be big for them in their quest for the playoffs. Alcatraz Inmate versus Blood God Despoilers. I'm going to go with the Inmates to win the Battle of the Chaos. Even though the more killy pieces are on the Blood God Despoilers, I'm expecting the good old Mano, Bernie the Mano, is going to get it done for the Alcatraz. Well, the Goblin Raptors against the Goblins. I've got to go with the Lizards, especially after your Lizard Harry smashed them last week. So I'll go with Goblin Raptors. And this is an interesting one. Detroit Beck Steelers versus your Lizard Harry. This is a really tough one. No Crux Gore in this either. I'm not exactly sure which one to go in that one. You just don't know what Steelers are going to turn up. So... Oh, God. That Croc's been out a massive miss. But you just don't know what you're going to get from the Steelers. The Steelers just want a scrap. I'm going to go with a draw. I think the Steelers can get something from this, just because the Croc's is out. But again, it just depends, really, what Steeler team turns up, really. or what Raziel Wolf's told them to do. Right, the final play pool then. Let's get these done. It's the Altdorf Bank side. This is where the champs are, the Blue Green Boys. Oh, they get smelly Wunderbands this week. Yes. That's the leaderboard then. Played 5, won 5. Yeah. This just looked a really, really good play pool for their pools. The only danger I thought from this play pool was probably going to be the Rifers. And they beat the Norse last week, as we're going to see in a minute. Ice Drake's done a really good. Won three, lost three. He's done all right. The Greenies Scissor Row was competitive. They're up there as well. So they're both fighting for a third spot. The Smelly Underpants at the moment, they're struggling. But again, they can still get it done. And then obviously Proud Stars not had a bad start. And now there's Crookbaggers. Crookbaggers had a really bad season, but they finally turned it around last week. And then poor old Cushy, propping them all up. And the Greenies has got it done this week as well. That's huge for them. So let's have a look at the attack itself. So Cushy got it done against the Dwarfs. A 2-0 win. 15 armor breaks. Jesus Christ. 15 armor breaks against AV9, mainly Dwarfs, is horrendous. But 50 blocks were thrown by the Dwarfs as well. This was an absolute slobber knocker. 91 blocks combined. Love it. 18% ball possession is a concern, though, for the Maulers. Dwarfs having 18% is not a good thing. But, yeah, they're certainly not to hit. 2 KOs, 3 injuries against 2 injuries. So, yeah. Absolute carnage. That's a big win for the Stealths. Really is. 16 XP as well for the Stealths. 12 for the Dwarfs. So they're not terrible for going forward, depending on if anything got broken that game. But yeah, very impressive victory for the Stealths. Really was. Looking at the team and then Stealths, yeah, they lost this week, didn't they? That's right. So, looking at the teams then, loves his death roll, that's proud. He's got a long bead missing at the moment. And the problem with this team, obviously, he's got the referee's rest area now, so at least he's got that now. The problem with this team, obviously, they just don't have a bench, and when you've got a death roller, you're in trouble. Especially against fast teams who can just score and just get rid of the death roll straight away. Obviously, if this team's at home, it does give them the advantage of having the death roll on for 2 drives. But also, the negative of that is obviously it gives a bribe to the opponents who can then foul your AV players on the floor. Obviously, the best way to break high AV teams is booting them on the floor, and if you've got a bribe, that helps, I guess. Looking at the team, though, it's a nice team. The guard's coming along nicely. They've got 5 guard. The Mighty Blow spam is going there as well. What they've got 7 Mighty Blow. So again, Dwarfs are always competitive regardless. But this team next season will be a lot better. My main point, I'm going to keep saying this until it's not an issue, is this team needs a bench. This team really needs 13 players. If you're going to roll in a death roll, you need 13 players. It's as simple as that. Because the death roller is only going to be guaranteed to be on for 1 drive. And that is a lot of TV for 1 drive. He's helped himself with the he's helped himself obviously with the bribe. But you're not always going to be playing at home. That's the issue. Was it in the Dark Stealths I played this week? Oh wow, that's massive, because I thought that was a Dark Fellows for some reason. So the Stealths losing week 6, that is massive. That's put the Greenses back in it, hasn't it? Right, okay. So let's have a look at the Stealths then. So if they'd have beaten the Goblins, they probably would have made the playoffs, the SAS playoffs. But they fluffed the lands a bit. Now this is a team what was interesting, because it rolled a couple of doubles, and Ice Drake went for Parley on instead of Mighty Blow, and it's worked out alright. But they're on a bit of a downward spiral at the moment. Played three. Let's have a look. So they won the first two games, but then only won one of the next four. And that was against the Dwarfs. So they really need to get it done in week seven to have any chance of making the big boys playoffs. The elite SES trophy. But his team, again, doing really well. I mean, they've only been... This is only their first season. And he's done really well to get XP nicely spread. He's got some dangerous pieces. Nice movement down the line as well to make it a bit quicker. He's obviously got movement 8 blitzer as well. He's got blotch on a few of his players. Diving tackle on another one. So, a couple of tackle there. So if he's in a tackle, if he's in a blotch heavy league next season, he's well fully equipped for that. So, you know, he's got a lot of bases covered. He just doesn't really, to me, have a ball carrier, not a designated ball carrier. That is the only, you know, that is the only one, really. That's the only negative I have. But again, the agility four, so they're picking up on tuples out of this, though. But yeah, it's a really good team. Unfortunately, they blew the lands in week six. But again, Dustbin is so good with goblins. He's done that to plenty of people. He won that long ago that he held Zerpul's Green Boy used to draws. So this season, he finally didn't. But yeah. Well, this was always going to be a tough one for the Norse against such a powerhouse team in the Green Boys. This team goes from strength to strength, this Orc team. It's going to take a good team to beat them. You just can't give 6-2 blocks away, not against them. The irony is, though, he only did 3 KOs and 2 injuries. That was the thing what surprised me more than anything. Because you're AV7, and he only removed 5 things. But he still got it done. Not brilliant XP, but decent enough for the Norse, and obviously 15 XP beautifully for the Green Boys. 50% ball possession. Like I said, 108 yards winning as well. They're just basically teams. Always going to be hard against for Valhalla. I think they'll be just happy they got away with it. I think, if I remember correctly, he wasn't playing that game either. So I think they'll just be happy that it's over and done with now. But look at this team. 7 guard. Strength 5. Blackhawk. Tackle. Got thrower. Troll as well. 13 players. This is about as good as you can get. He's carrying 50k blow as well. So he's actually 1940. The one first season of Sunderland Schools, I'll tell you what, it's going to take a very good team to stop them this season as well. Already qualified for the Sunderland Schools playoffs already. You know, one of the best coaches on the PlayStation circuit, I think, and that's fair to say. He, just about everywhere he goes, he's won something. You know? Real nice guy as well. Real nice guy. That always helps, I always think. But yeah. When was the last time he got beat? I think it was Dragoon who beat him. I think that was the last time this guy got beat. There it is there. And the lizard's far, far away. So 1-2. Yeah. 11 games ago. It's when he got beat. Look at that. He beat the Blue Book Believers, the Average Joes, and the Deceased Stub Skulls. Three of the big teams from Season 1. He beat to get that trophy. So he did it the hard way. It was not an easy route. Can he get it done this time? Or will Average Joe's get the revenge? Who knows? So the Norse. So they've got Berserker missing. Oh, he's AV6. That's a shame. He's got his AV7 Yeti back as well. So this thing is good. The thing is with that Yeti though, he could get rid of it. Because, I don't know. It's not got blocked. So I'd quite easily let that go. Maybe not now, but end of season, try and maybe bring in a replacement. Shame about the Berserker, though. That's a crying shame. This is a typical Norse team. It's a bit bashed up. Be interesting to see if Rafus comes back with Norse. Or try something different. The Yetis haven't had, any of the Yetis haven't done very well this season, have they? To be fair. This is nice, though. Actually, for a runner. And then, obviously, a sure-handed runner as well. Obviously, this guy's good. This guy's good as well, but he's only a V6 now, so it's even worse. AG Daniel for one is not terrible. It just feels this team's just a bit bashed up. The Scavengers got a good win against the Goblins. That's a big win, because the Goblins have been doing pretty well. Only 3 armor breaks as well. They actually got outbashed by the Goblins, but still found a way to win. So that's good for Robo. It's good that his team got it done against a very good Goblin team. So I'm really happy for him there. 56% ball possession. Sort of tried to dictate it against Goblins. 106 yards running as well. 14 XP against 12. Yeah, that's not bad. Yeah, not really much to say. I mean, like I said, the old beer 2 stands. I love that. Like I said, these Goblins are always well coached by Dustbin. So for him to get it, to be able to turn his fortune around and get a win there, that is massive for Robo Will. Green says he'd like to develop his Goblin team where Tony tries to keep him as cheap as possible. I love this guy, the fanatic. Block and might blow. He's got a chainsaw. He likes his bombers. He'd love to see his trolls get in some block though if he could. A nice blodge sidestepping Goblin there. Another blodge Goblin there. Leo DiPinci. What a name. So he is developing some nice Goblins. He really is. So although they went down this week, we know that they went and won the week after, so it gives them a chance. Obviously got enough old altar as well. I mean, they even beat the Dwarfs. That's impressive. Really is. And Robo Will, so he finally gets himself a win. What's good. Again, very, very early developed team. Doing them proud. And there we go. DP, looking good. And that was an admin result. So, I'm going to go with the Green Boys to beat the Underpants. The Maulers to beat the Fellows. And I'm going to give Valhalla against the Scavengers. And my nap will be Valhalla drinking team to beat the Quarterback Center. So the Triple B Banquet is going to the Norse. And there we go. That's it. We're done. Done and dusted. I've had to quickly just cut it short here because this recording is going to go off in a second. So, good luck to everybody. And we'll see ya next week to find out who's making the playoffs and who isn't. Take care, guys. Bye-bye. Never be myself. Take me right.